campaigners against gay marriage have been hitting the streets of Cornwall, asking people to write to their MPs. They've been targeting the Tories in particular, and perhaps with good reason. Giles Chichester is one of several Conservatives in the South West who don't like plans for equal marriage. And he says David Cameron is alienating the grassroots, as Johnny Rutherford reports.
Last weekend, hundreds of thousands of people from across France rallied in Paris against their government's plans to legalise same-sex marriage. Meanwhile, in Cornwall, the Coalition for Marriage has been leafleting people about Downing Street's plans to do something similar. The government want to rewrite the meaning of marriage. But to change the definition of an institution that's been around for thousands of years certainly isn't an easy one. And it's splitting the views of the general public and the politicians themselves.
I'm very disappointed that David Cameron, and I think it's very personal, has chosen to take this initiative. It wasn't in the manifesto. There's no great call for it. I support equal rights for gay couples. That's been legislated for already. If it ain't broke, why fix it?
The Coalition for Marriage presented a petition to Number 10 with thousands of signatures against the proposed redefinition. And Giles Chichester says he's had a very strong response from his constituents and members of the party against David Cameron's proposal.
Almost without exception, they say, why is he doing it? There's no call for it. He's got enough problems to tackle without making a big one like this.
This week, the Sunday Politics asked all 14 Conservative MPs in the South West where they sit on gay marriage. Only two, Sarah Wollison and Hugo Swire, were clear in their support for the plans. Five of them expressed strong views against gay marriage, including Anne-Marie Morris, Neil Parish, Mel Stride, Richard Drax and Ian Liddell Granger. The position of the remaining seven Conservative MPs in the region remains unclear. The Coalition for Marriage is asking people in Cornwall's Conservative constituencies to write to their MPs opposing gay marriage, but Sarah Newton says she's being misrepresented.
What I do object to, and I have objected to the Coalition for Marriage in this particular leaflet, is the impression that it's given a lot of my constituents that actually I'm endorsing their campaign.
The UK Independence Party is hoping to poach disillusioned Tory voters with its clear opposition to gay marriage. The issue is so important, it's said to have cost the leader of its youth section his job after he spoke out in favour of gay marriage.
Pushing for gay marriage, which is something I'm a big supporter of, it's one of the few things I think this government is doing right. So I think that there's definitely a more socially liberal side of Young Independents. I think that's a really good thing.
I have no problem with him being a supporter of gay marriage. It's because as a spokesman for the party, and I'm the chairman of the party, as a spokesman for the party, we did ask him to stay within sort of representing party policy. And on a number of issues, of which gay marriage was one, that wasn't really happening.
The Bishop of Exeter has been very clear about his opposition to gay marriage.
The proposals as they stand have many unforeseen legal and constitutional consequences which the government have not thought through. I hear more and more people becoming concerned about those consequences and saying, look, slow down, we need to do the thinking, we need to be doing the talking about what's really involved here.
David Cameron says marriage should be an institution open to everyone. The bill is due later this year and it could be law by 2014.
Johnny Rutherford reporting, and we're joined now by Dr Sharon James from the Coalition for Marriage from Truro. Welcome to the programme. You're against these plans to allow gay marriage. Can you tell us why?
The Coalition for Marriage is representing people up and down the country, Lucy, people of faith and people of no faith at all, who believe that this government didn't create marriage. It goes right back to the beginning of recorded history. It's a natural institution between a man and a woman. And while with the great majority of the British public are very tolerant, we believe that gay and lesbian couples have the right to live as they please. We're hearing from many gay and lesbian couples who are happy with civil partnerships, but we don't believe the government has the right to redefine marriage over the heads, I might say, of millions of married people.
OK, but the proposals do offer now protection to the Church of England not to include gay marriage. Why hasn't that removed the problem for you?
Well, one of the top human rights lawyers in the country has delivered a 44-page opinion saying that the so-called quadruple lock is eminently legally challengeable, saying that all of these so-called protections are fairly meaningless. The European Court of Human Rights would be able to drive a coach and horses through all of them. And the people that we represent are not actually so much worried about the rights of a few individual ministers. What our supporters worry about is the civic liberties of ordinary people, teachers, parents, foster parents, public sector workers who are already finding their liberties threatened in an increasingly hostile climate to those who believe in traditional marriage. Just in 2011,
what is it that you actually want, though, from the Conservatives in Cornwall? You're targeting Conservatives in Cornwall. What is it that you want from them?
Well, we want every MP to listen to the views of their constituents, and we're finding that when people find out about this, they've not been properly informed, but when people do find out about these plans, they're very unhappy about them. And of course they have the right to contact their MP, make their views known. And we're hearing from MPs up and down the country who are saying they've got more posts on this issue against gay marriage than on any other issue that has ever come up.
All right,
there's an overwhelming feeling.
Let's just move to Marcus. You support gay marriage. In our survey, then, you're Conservative. Only two Conservatives MPs in the region, of 14, actually support it, and five are actively opposed to it.
Yes.
I mean, is it likely to become a reality?
I can't answer. I don't know. I mean, how the voting falls is another question, but I don't think... you know, one of the issues is the lot of Conservative members, and I think Giles has alluded to this, are in favour with that lady in terms of opposing this. But the vast majority of the public support it, and I think that when you're a government, you have to govern for all the people. You can't just do what your own party members want. And I think there is enough evidence that having given in and accepted gay civil partnerships, really, it's inevitable that gay marriage would come along. I can't see why you'd say that one's all right and the other one isn't, really.
Is now the right time, though, to be introducing these measures?
Well, is any time the right time to do something controversial? It's always going to cause a lot of upset, particularly for people who feel, as I'm sure that lady does, very, very passionately about it. But for the vast majority of the public, I think they all feel we've crossed that. We crossed that threshold when we had the debate about civil partnerships.
And in fact, that moves us nicely to you, Luke. Why did Labour not introduce gay marriage? Why this half measure of civil partnerships? This could have been sorted out earlier, couldn't it?
Well, throughout the 13 years of Labour government, there was a huge step forward in gay equality, the equalisation of the age of consent, ability to adopt, and actually, we think marriage is a good thing. More people should get married. And actually, extending it to everyone, regardless of their sexuality, is only going to increase the happiness of everyone. These proposals, very importantly, don't take anything away from anyone who is already married. It simply extends the right to marry, to be in a marriage to anyone in the country. And that surely has to be a good thing. It's very rare government can extend happiness in any policy. This is one where they can.
Sharon, it has to be a good thing. You've heard the gentleman in the studio here. What do you say to them?
Well, I would simply say that this will take away the freedom from those vast numbers of the British public who do not believe that marriage is the same as same-sex unions. And if people are already under threat of losing their jobs if they disagree with gay marriage, what will the situation be if gay marriage is introduced? And I would say again that people on both sides of the argument are asking the government to pause and consider what could well be the unintended consequences. Very senior politicians on both sides are saying this policy has not been properly thought through. The government should not be rushing it through.
Dr. Sharon James, thank you very much for joining us.